This book made me cry and it's one of my most favorite books. Hello, I'm Neetu and welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to talk about some great books that I discovered at the secondhand bookstore, and I've not heard a lot of booktubers or bookstagrammers talk about these books, but I actually think they deserve a shout out. So the first book is The Dark Hills Divide by Patrick Carman. This book is the first book of the Land of Aliens series, and it follows the story of this girl named Alexa who travels to a fictional city called Brightville, which is surrounded by huge walls. And the story follows how she discovers what lies beyond the walls and why the wall was built in the first place. And this book contains a lot of fantasy elements that I love to read, and that includes a mysterious house, some magical gems and talking animals, among a few others. So this book is a relatively small read. If you can see here, there are around 5 books in the series, and also it has some illustrations of the map. This is Brightville, and I think this is a great book for kids and adults alike. The next book is The Dragons of Ordinary Farm by Tad Williams and Deborah Beale. So this book is about siblings Lucinda and Tyler who visit their uncle's farm during the summer vacations. So this farm is actually called the Ordinary Farm, but it's anything but ordinary. You'll find dragons and flying monkeys in the stables rather than cows or sheep. So when the farm is threatened, it's up to them to save the day. This book is around 400 pages long, and there are 2 books in this series. I really like the parts where the kids discover some rather unsettling secrets about the house, and in general, it's a really good book. So the next book is the Septimus Heap series by Angie Sage. And this book is about a boy named Septimus Heap, who is the 7th son of a 7th son, and so is prophesied to be a great wizard. So he has to train under the extraordinary wizard for 7 years and a day before he can qualify as the extraordinary wizard himself. If you enjoyed reading Harry Potter, then this is the book for you. I thought Harry Potter was a very structured story, but when it comes to Septimus Heap, things are very chaotic here. This book has some really amazing characters and a great storyline. So there are 7 books in this series, and they are a bit on the longer side, but they are so good. And this book also has a really great illustration of this map. So the next book in this list is If You Could See Me Now by Cecilia Ahern. So this book follows the story of Elizabeth, who lives with her nephew Luke, and she leads this rather boring and monotonous lifestyle. But things are about to change when a new character enters their life, and his name is Ivan. This book made me cry and it's one of my most favorite books. I'm not going to give away any spoilers because I really want you all to go and read this one. This was the only standalone book in this list. Okay, and last but not the least, Flowers in the Attic by V.C. Andrews. So this is actually a gothic family drama kind of book, but it can easily qualify as a horror book for all the controversial things that happen in there. So this book is about 4 siblings who are locked up and hidden away from the world in an attic by their mother and grandmother. And it basically follows all the hardship and trauma that they had to go through throughout these years. And let me tell you, I only added this book in this list because the author's writing style is just amazing, and she keeps her audiences engaged with just that. And this book has around 4 or 5 others coming behind them, and I've read only the first one of it because just to see how far she'll go with the story, and you'll have to read it to know how different it is. So that's it. I'll leave the links down in the description box for all the books that I have mentioned in this video. If you enjoyed it, please do like, share and subscribe. Stay safe. See you next time.